I present to you a new type of photography, femto photography, a new imaging technique so fast that you can create slow motion videos of light in motion.
One way to put it on the scale of all of the different things that are happening in nature is that femtosecond is shorter compared to a minute, as a minute is short compared to the age of the universe. So we're really talking about our own time scale, which is the time scale of seconds and minutes, being midway between the femtosecond world and the world of the longest timescales we know about, the age of the universe. The theory of light that we now understand to be correct has as its parents both Newton and Huygens, but at the time they thought that they had completely different and incompatible theories. Newton's theory of light was that light was a stream of particles. Huygens' theory of light was that light was a wave phenomenon. Neither understood that they were both right. And it is, in fact, this introduction of the quantum theory which allows us to have a particle which is also a wave with no inconsistency that unites them. In the quantum world, the world where femtosecond processes happen, we also have a different kind of mechanics, something called quantum mechanics. This is not anything that we can change. It's simply the way the world is. On very small distance scales, things move and act differently than what we're used to in the large scale.
What goes on these timescales? How do atoms move? How do molecules move? Having a look into it, seeing things on timescales that we've never seen before can tell us a lot about what's going on in molecules and atoms, and this can lead to things like femtochemistry and atto science, and yeah, so it just opens up a lot of doors to things that we haven't seen before.
The whole reason that we can get to this extremely short timescale is because we have the ability using lasers to control the properties of light. We can make femto movies, femtosecond scale movies. We can do that. We can't, of course, see that. It's faster than the blink of an eye, so we have to slow it down. And the method that's used to slow it down is what you might think of as stroboscopic photography. And we can think of our light sources that are on the femtosecond scale as even more brief flashes of light. But in order to string the images captured by those flashes into a movie, we have to collect them one snapshot at a time and then put them together later.
An attosecond is 1 times 10 to the minus 18 seconds. That is 0.00170 zeros, 1 seconds. 1 femtosecond is equal to 1,000 attoseconds. This is the kind of timescales where atomic dynamics occur.
In our lab, we try to achieve attosecond timescale resolution in different systems. So we wanna see how a system behaves, say an atom or a molecule, in this timescale that is very, very short.
If we have these pulses of these durations, we can actually have a look at these dynamics, see how things like electrons move or act in atoms, which is really exciting and something we want to know about and know about in nature. And the possibilities of once we know about these things, what we could do and how we could apply them are endless.
A natural partnership between scientists whose science is collected mostly through images, like astrophysicists and like the people in my field who work in looking at images on the femtosecond scale. There's a natural connection between those people and the creative artistic community. It's one of the reasons why images from the Hubble Space Telescope are so extremely popular, even though the people who download them don't really have the technical knowledge to understand what they're seeing. They understand that it's very beautiful and also that it's real.
See around corners and really challenge what we mean by a camera. The idea is that we're going to shine some light on the door. It's going to bounce, go inside the room. Some of that are going to reflect back on the door and then back to the camera. And we're going to exploit this multiple bounces of light.
I think this is useless and a bit weird.
Wind up on it.
I think you're a wind up. Very rarely am I trying to take pictures of something round a corner.
Just go around the corner and see what was there.
I could see what people were doing before I went into a room. I guess filmmakers are finding some use for it as well.
Quite interesting to get unobserved pictures of people so they don't know, because people change when they know they're being filmed.
I think you'd have problems with privacy.
I guess surveillance companies are finding some use for it.
Probably useful in the military.
For a spying purpose.
I think there's already enough places where cameras are being used.
I can't think of any other practical use other than spying on people, which is not terribly great, but you know, I think that's the only practical use you get for it.
I don't know. It's a bit, I've never thought about having a camera that could see around corners. Use it for perving on people. Well, I shouldn't say that, I'm a nun. Let's hear that.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.